basketball in the Filipino community is like the blood in terms of the young people showcasing their skills, showcasing their skills, showcasing their skills. Filipino basketball has been around for more than 50 years, and it's only now that we're spotlighting those stories. So when I started playing basketball, I didn't know how big the culture was, and there was different teams, different organizations. Think about a young kid playing basketball against teams that are far, far away from US, from Canada. And I was from Richmond Hill, so playing against even just Mississauga teams was such a shock for me and gave me such adrenaline. And that's how I fell in love with it, because of that just culture. And I became, you know, in love with basketball.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. I will do layups. At least they should be able to make at least 50 within 3 minutes.
50 layups.
50 layups, di ba? Nag-miss. Nawala yung bola. So, di ba?
We want everybody to run. If you don't make 50, we're gonna do it again. Basically, if you're two pass away, okay, you gotta help. You gotta help right in the middle, right here. Okay, even if it's a man to man, okay, just have to see where you. Whenever you're two pass away, somebody has to be here to help. Okay, let's go.
My name is Penola. Compared to other guys, I started basketball when I was in grade 8. I was a baseball player at first, and then I moved to Ajax, and I met some new friends that love basketball, so I started playing with these guys, and then since then I've never stopped learning basketball. I played 2 years at Ateneo University over in the Philippines. Unfortunately, I got hurt. I tore my ACL, tore my meniscus on the same knee, so it kind of like slowed me down in terms of like professional basketball. But, you know, I still play in, as you can see, local men's leagues, pickup runs, stuff like that. So hopefully I can play as long as I can, you know, hopefully until I'm old as well. Play with my son one day, hopefully. And yeah, man, I just love the game, man. Without these leagues in the GTA, man, like, I don't know where ballers would like play in leagues, to be honest. Like, I think Megacity is the original league that ever did like start up huge in the GTA. So I mean, recreation wise, the men's leagues are huge in Toronto.
Kumusta kayo lahat? Welcome to Pinoy Crossover, the basketball show for the Filipino community. My name is PJay.
Pinoy Crossover came from a frustration that stories aren't being left untold. There's legends in Filipino basketball. For example, Dean Labayan, who no one knows about, but he attracted crowds at the Fil-Can tournament. And there used to be only one basically big Filipino basketball tournament. Now there's three or four. It stemmed from the fact that no one's covering Filipino basketball. Obviously, when I played, I wanted to be spotlighted. I thought I was good. And there's a lot of kids that are better than me. And I really want to spotlight that. And our team really wants to tell those stories, because I feel like it should be told and good players are not getting the recognition they deserve.
Oh, a good drive. That's McLean. Wow. With the contact. Beast mode.
Generation gives back, because a lot of players that played in tournaments and leagues coach, and also parents are not far away from that, because you see dads coaching their sons, and you see, you know, brothers and sisters and, you know, family really cheering them on every game. So it's become really interwoven with the Filipino culture. And as you know, in the Philippines, basketball, obviously the professional basketball league is big, and basketball is a pastime, whether it be from, you know, in the street playing with basically ghetto rings. It's just been the blood and the pulse of Filipinos are in basketball. So it's part of the culture.
basketball is such a tight-knit community that like everyone knows who can play. And because of that factor, that culture that people talk and talk, and the talent-wise has becoming like more and more great. Like there's Filipino-Canadians that are making it in Philippines. Some notables are Matthew Wright, who's now basically the face of Filipino-Canadians, and he's playing for Gilas, which is the national team. So you have talents that are rising, and you have young kids that are playing in Philippines, and it's just a great time to really spotlight all these Filipino basketball players, and it's just a culture that's worth getting into if you play basketball, and if you don't know about it, there's a team somewhere.